Pricing the hotel rooms right, 24/7. We have studied before that a hotel cannot depend on just the two old metrics of financial performance. Occupancy percent, average daily rate. Let us first review why we cannot depend on these two metrics alone. If we just look at the occupancy percent, any hotel can fill its rooms by giving very high amount of discount. But will that fill our bank account? ADR, in its calculation formula, has number of rooms sold in the denominator. A hotel of 500 rooms can sell just 50 rooms, all at the highest rate, and achieve perfect ADR figures. Will that fill our bank account? Will it produce enough income to cover the high level of fixed costs most hotels have to meet every month, every day? That is why the metric of RevPAR was needed to measure performance. It is revenue from all available rooms, and if many rooms are vacant, RevPAR will certainly be low. If we give a lot of discount and fill rooms, RevPAR would still be low. This concept will become even clearer when we discuss yield percent metric and yield management. What is hotel pricing strategy? Hotel dynamic pricing, also known as demand pricing, time-based pricing, or surge pricing, is the practice of changing room rates daily, even at multiple times during the day, based on real-time market demand data, coming in from all the distribution channels through which a hotel sells its rooms. Real-time is same as live update. Pricing strategy is based on the simple law of demand and law of supply that most of us have studied in economics during high school. When demand is high, prices usually increase. For example, during New Year's Eve, rates rise due to a surge of celebrating tourists. When demand is low, prices usually decrease. For example, a hotel in a small beach town will generally drop their rates during winter. What to know when developing a smart hotel pricing strategy? Overall room availability in our area. Are there any important events happening that will increase demand? Local knowledge and contacts help. Competitor availability. How are our competitors doing? If they only have a few rooms available, we can increase our rates, which will help us increase our average daily rate. Cancellation policies. Can we offer non-refundable rates? It assures us of an income and makes the guest more careful. Inventory management. Keeping a record of all our market segments, who book at that particular time, which channel they prefer to use, and how much commission the hotel has to pay for each reservation. We aim to fill the rooms with those guests who will spend the most in our hotel premises. Cost per room. The hotel must calculate the cost per occupied room to check if our rate will generate a profit margin. Remember lose-it rates? Consider staff, housekeeping costs, cleaning supplies, consumable amenities, such as shampoo and conditioner, laundry charges of bed and bath linens, utilities, such as electricity, and booking fees, and compensation. It's also a good idea to allocate an amount towards future renovations. This cost per occupied room figure helps us to calculate GOPPAR. Common mistakes in pricing decisions. Filling rooms much before the date of arrival. Not all guests buy in the same way. A hotel must wait for the most profitable business till the date of arrival. Pricing as you like it. Data is always more reliable than what we think will happen. There are factors like weather, local event, emergencies that could drastically change demand. We always need to do some math check. Keeping a constant fixed rate. Some guests may like our simplicity, but most guests are now used to paying higher prices during high demand period. Make money or go out of business. Changing prices only during daytime, not at night. Murphy's Law says, if anything can go wrong, it will. Internet and smartphones, ODA, GDS etc. have made the booking process open 24 hours. The demand has to be constantly watched, and prices need to be adjusted, by someone knowledgeable, and responsible, even during graveyard shift. Night Auditor could do that. Closing some distribution channels. Closing a channel, is like closing the doors, on the segment, which books through that channel. They may be disappointed, not to find our hotel in the search results, especially if it's a repeat business. These days, loyalty is less important than convenience. Knee-jerk reactions to competitors' price changes. Just as two guests are not the same, no two hotels are similar either. Competitor pricing gives us a better idea of overall demand in our market, but we should never react to just one competitor's rates. They may be adjusting their rates because they might have received bookings or cancellations. It could even be a case of, as I like it, type of pricing. If the whole comp set is resetting prices, then it must be something serious. Presented by Praveen Jha, Senior Lecturer.